Alex. This is your forever final girl, Rachel. Here to do some scratch, scratch, scratching. I'm also going to give you my thoughts on the movie Scream 2022. Scream 2022 is the first movie in a long, long time that I was super pumped to see. And the first Scream movie I got to see in the theaters. And it lived up to the hype. I love feeling that anticipation to the other movie. watching Stab movie, Randy yelling at the TV while Ghostface was behind him and was behind her at the same time. Mindy following in her uncle's footsteps and being the horror movie geek of the group was pretty cool. Like I said earlier, the kills and even the original tech are more brutal and bloodier than before. I feel that it adds more tension and makes the movie darker than previous movies. And now for the negatives. Some of my negatives are probably just nitpicks, but I feel like I need to get them out and see if I'm the only one who feels this way. First off, Dewey's death. Now, I'm not mad that they killed him off. I understand why they did it. It's more how they did it. The man survived four other killing sprees, and he does a boneheaded move, like going back alone to shoot Ghostface in the head. Dewey, even though in the past he was a big goofy, wouldn't have done that. Also, I think they did a huge disservice with his characters in regards to his and Gale's relationship. There's no way Dewey would have left Gale in the middle of the night like a coward. No way. Now for a break. I just joined the Amazon Partner Program, so if you click the Amazon links in the description, I may earn a small commission on your purchases, which helps to support my channel. Thank you. Character development is a big issue for me in this movie. I've already mentioned Dewey, but the other circle of friends weren't fleshed out enough for me to really care if they died or not. They were just bodies for the killer. I know this movie is supposed to be a passing of the torch for the franchise, but if I want to continue with this series, I need to actually feel for the safety of the characters. And I honestly didn't really care either way for most of them. Then my issue is with the killers and their reason for killing. First, having the boyfriend as the killer was way too obvious. Come on, I figured out at the very beginning. And then have Amber as the other killer. We barely see her throughout the movie and then bam, she's the other killer. It just doesn't sit well with me. Finally, the whole reason they are killing people is because they didn't like how the last Stab movie was. Really? Come on. I understand the mother's revenge for the second movie. I understood, but didn't like the unknown half-brother, and even the one where the family member was overshadowed by Cindy and just wanted attention for herself. But the reason being they didn't like a movie is just ridiculous. Overall, I did like Scream 2022. They upped the violence and gave us some good conclusions to our OG players. I do think they did a good job overall passing the torch. It's not the worst movie in the franchise, and I did enjoy it a lot. I will be buying it the first chance I get. I also will go and see it in the theater again. Now, for some behind-the-scenes information. David Arquette, who is a certified Bob Ross painting instructor, taught several of the cast members how to paint like the legendary artist during filming breaks. A lot of the crew members who worked on this film also worked on Dawson's Creek, and he was playing on the TV when Tara was in the hospital. When Richie is watching a YouTube video about Stab 8, one of the thumbnail recommendations is an interview with Woodsboro survivor Kirby Reed. Ghostface in Scream 2022 follows the rules of a requel, a sequel in a franchise that goes back to the roots of the original installment in a franchise. This trend in slasher horror was popularized by Halloween 2018. Nick Cave and the Bad Seed song Red Right Hand, which was in every Scream movie but Scream 4, was put on My Ghostface by Ghostface in Vince's car before his murder. When we see Dewey's trailer, there is an urn on a bookshelf engraved with the name Tatum, his younger sister, who died in the original film. Amber is the second female Ghostface killer to kill the most people after Jill in Scream 4. First Scream film where neither of the killers have a motive against Sydney. Let's get into the rankings. For kills, blood, and gore, I give it a 5 out of 5. Sex and nudity at 0 out of 5. Scare factor, 3.5 out of 5. Enjoyment factor, 5 out of 5. My rank, 3.5 out of 5. Click the link in the description to visit foreverfinalgirl.com for more reviews. Just remember, even the worst movies have something positive about it. Happy nightmares, 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 nightmares. Happy nightmares.